Welcome to my secret place devotion with Oyiks Alfred. The Word of God is alive and equipped to change your life.
Good morning. I declare over your life from Philippians chapter 4 verse 6 that you will rejoice in the Lord today. You will rejoice in the Lord tomorrow. You will always rejoice in the Lord in the name of Jesus. Nothing will steal your joy. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Today we're answering a question sent in by one of our listeners, and it has to do with the marriage question. It says, "Dear Ma, thank you so much for the opportunity to ask questions about something we don't understand in scripture. My question is, why do I not get answers to certain prayers? For example, my prayer for a spouse. It feels like God is ignoring me when it comes to that aspect of my life." So quickly, let me let you know that there are many reasons why there could be delay in marriage in terms of getting a life partner. There are many reasons, but let me break it down into two groups. You have the physical reasons why there's delay, and you have the spiritual reasons why there's delay. Now, because I can't be specific to the particular individual, because, you know, I really don't know you, but I'm just going to give you general things that could cause delay physically. Number one, sometimes people set unrealistic standards and expectations. So people come around them and they kind of, you know, blow them off because, oh, this is not the kind of person I want. That's not the kind of person I want. I'm not saying you should marry everybody, but make sure that your standards and your expectations are realistic. Number two, physical appearance. You know, a lot of men are moved by what they see. So sometimes our appearance is rough. We look dirty. We look untidy. Another reason is when you give off masculine vibes if you're a woman, and you give off feminine vibes if you're a man. Now, a man doesn't want to marry another man. So a lot of women are not positioned like women, that they are soft and tender and gentle, that somebody wants to take care of you. You know, another reason is not being able to manage people. Some people just don't know how to manage relationships. They don't know how to manage human beings. And I often say that if you don't understand people management, then you don't have a ministry, you don't have a marriage, you don't have anything. You must learn how to manage people, because you live in a world with people. There are so many reasons for that. Another reason, again, is missing seasons. Now, for every single thing, the Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1, for every single thing, there is a purpose, there is a time, there is a season for you to do every single thing that God has designed for you to do on earth. Now, what a lot of people do is when the season for marriage comes, they cultivate the wrong things. They don't start, you know, prayerfully looking for, okay, Lord, is this the person you want me to marry? Is this a good idea for me to go ahead? Though all those things are not in their heads, yeah? And then when the season passes, you now start praying and fasting for what you could have gotten on a platter of gold when the season for that marriage, you know, was around. And how you know the season is gone? All of a sudden, people start taking note of you and all of that. So if you're a woman, you should know, okay, this is the season. Same thing for men. So let's take a look at some of the spiritual reasons why there could be delay. Number one, satanic blockages. You know, there could be demonic things that are preventing people from getting married. There's something the Bible calls the covering cast. You see it in Isaiah 25 verse 7. He says, "He will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all the people, and the veil that is spread over all the nations." Now, this covering cast is a spiritual casting on a person that makes you invisible. People see you, but they can't see you. I've had to personally deal with so many of these cases, people who are covered. So people want to marry you, they don't recognize you, or they don't think of you in line or in the lines of getting married and all of that. You're just covered. It happens to people, it happens to businesses, it happens to, you know, so many things. You lose visibility, and it's a spiritual thing. There's nothing you can do in the physical. You might be pretty, you might be well dressed, you might be everything, but people just don't see you. It's a spiritual casting that prevents a lot of men and women from getting married. There are spiritual interferences that happen. Sometimes it's patterns in families and all of that. You see that in your family, it's very difficult for people to get married. Or sometimes you could see in families, it might not be marriage particularly, but before they get anything, they have to struggle so hard. Something that is easy for others becomes very difficult. Before you get one thing, you have to do a lot of prayer and all of that. You know that you're dealing with spiritual powers that are interfering with you getting married. Another reason for delay is simply people who lack favor. You need to ask God for favor that attracts marriage. If that particular type of favor is not on your life, you're going to have a lot of delay concerning marriage. Another reason is that some people just don't know how to pray the right prayers. A lot of times they say, oh, Pastor, I've prayed about this for the past 10 years, 12 years. And normally my question is, what is the content of your prayer? 99% of the time, the content of their prayer is wrong. At some point, I'm going to deal with prayers at the devotional. Maybe I'll take a whole month series on how to pray and get results. One of the things that Christians don't understand is how to pray and get results. God wants to answer our prayers. The Bible says in Psalm 65 verse 2, he says, "For you answer our prayers. All of us must come to you. Though we are overwhelmed by our sins, you forgive them all." So the Bible is saying that God is the one that answers prayers, and that's why everybody comes to him. The Bible says God is attentive to the prayer of the righteous, but the prayer of the sinner is an abomination unto him. So if you are a child of God, meaning that you are genuinely following the Lord from the depths of your heart, you're living in righteousness, and you're doing your best to advance the kingdom of God, God will come through for you, because he made a promise to us in Matthew chapter 6 verse 33, and he says to us that if we seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and every other thing we need will be added unto us. He said, I know you need all these things. You need a husband, you need clothes, you need a job. He said, but seek my kingdom, seek my righteousness, and every other thing will be added. One more thing I'd like to add. Sometimes if you're a child of God, God will want to slow down your marriage process just a little bit, just because he prefers you to find your assignment in life, so that you're able to make the right choice in terms of, you know, a life partner. So you see him prompting you and pulling you in the area of the call of God upon your life, and then when you start that assignment, then God is able to say, okay, you know what, you cannot make a choice in terms of who your life partner is. You will not make a wrong choice, because the moment you understand what God has called you to do, you're able to make better and smarter decisions concerning marriage. Okay, I sure hope that this helps answering a question concerning why we have delay in marriage. Thank you so much for being a part of today's question and answer session. God bless you. See you again tomorrow.
For other life-changing messages, you can now download the app Rev Oyiks Speaks from Play Store for Android phone users or Apple Store for iOS users. You can also follow us on Instagram, YouTube, and Telegram, all on the handle Oyiks Alfred.
It's what I long for. Righteousness is what I need.